Hi folks, this is one of my rare videos, and since I'm not a YouTuber, the image quality isn't as good as in other videos here on YouTube. But first things first, what is a lock time? When you're firing a gun, you pull the trigger. At a certain point, the trigger releases the spring, and the time from this point until the hammer strikes the firing pin and the firing pin strikes the primer is called the lock time. And the next question is how to measure lock times, in my example on shotguns. In my simple experiment, I use a power supply and my oscilloscope. First, I hook up the system case with a positive line of my power supply. Now all the metal parts are positively charged. Even the hammer and the trigger and the firing pin. Now I need a contact that sits right behind the trigger and is isolated to the rest of the metal parts. When the trigger is pulled, the trigger closes the contact between the positive line of the power supply and contact 1. At the same time, on the mechanical part, it releases the spring. The spring accelerates the hammer and the hammer strikes the firing pin, then the firing pin strikes the primer. Since the primer is connected to contact 2, the firing pin closes the contact between the positive charged case of the gun and contact 2. In my experiment, I took a small metal contact and soldered a wire to it. It was then hot glued as a trigger stop behind the trigger. I adjusted the contact that there was a small gap between the trigger and the contact right after releasing the spring. The second contact, the primer, is made out of the dummy round that comes with my Beretta shotgun. So I drilled a hole in the bottom of the cartridge and wired it up with the spring inside, which is connected with a metal dummy primer. After that, I had to put some duct tape on the metal primer, otherwise it will close the contact. Right after, I put the dummy round into my barrels and closed the gun. Last but not least, I had to hook up a wire from the metal parts of the gun to the power supply, as you can see in the picture. In the next picture, you can see my experiment just with the gun, the power supply and the oscilloscope. I hooked the two contacts to my oscilloscope and put the oscilloscope in a single trigger mode. After dry firing, you can see the following image in the screen. The yellow line shows the contact of the trigger, which is pressed and then stays at a level of about 3.3 volts. Then after a short time, the bluish line goes to 3.3 volts. And the time between the rising edge of the yellow line and the rising edge of the bluish line is our lock time. The second shotgun I tested is my Beretta DT11 shotgun, which is more modern, expensive and state of the art. After my little experiment, I thought about the errors that could happen in the measurements. First of all, in the major error is the gap between the trigger and the contact. This gap should be as narrow as possible to get good measurements. If you got the same results when you slowly pull the trigger or fastly pull the trigger, then the gap should be as close as possible. The second is the reaction of the primer, which is not of interest because it depends on your ammunition and not on your shotgun. There were also electrical errors when I pulled the trigger because of the resistance of my skin. The next time I should ground the shotgun and the metal parts of the system. Another error was the capacity or inductance of the wires, but I think, as you can see on the scope, the signal was quite good, so I don't think it has much influence of the time I measured. So if you like the video, please give it a big thumbs up. With many likes, I could probably ask some manufacturers of shotguns to give me their products to test it. And please feel free to comment the video. See you next time.